So a package came in the mail today, and lo and behold, it's from noissue.co. Before anything else, can we just appreciate the packaging for a moment? Like, look at this. Isn't that like so cute? So the package includes 50 cards. I didn't really know what to have them print out at first, but I knew I wanted art prints. I ended up picking one of my favorite illustrations for the print and a little cake at the back with a thank you. They turned out really nice. The paper quality is matte and thick. The printing looks crisp as well. I plan on giving these to my friends and family, and if I have any left, I'll probably include them in packages or maybe a giveaway in the future. So I've never worked with a brand like Noissue before. They're known for being kind of like a one-stop shop for sustainable but pretty packaging. But since I don't have a shop as of yet, I haven't really looked into eco-friendly packaging. I think it's great that there are brands like this who care about the environment. All of their products claim to be either compostable, recycled, or reusable. And apparently they plant one tree per order for areas in need to help the world's reforestation. And you know, like, isn't that really thoughtful? Anyways, my mom recycles almost everything, but I am still learning and trying to educate myself more on about being eco-friendly. In the other box, we have a stamp. Can we just appreciate this packaging? The stamp comes with a really big ink pad, which I appreciate because I find it really hard to find ink pads of this size, and I was kind of looking for one, so this is great. And if I'm not mistaken, it also uses soy ink, which is really cool. I tested it out on a craft sticky note and it stamped really well. I haven't had the best experience with custom stamps, so I was pleasantly surprised with this one. I don't exactly know what I'll be using this for at the moment, but I'll be sure to stamp this on packages in the future. Once I start my own shop, it's nice to know that there's a brand like this that already has everything you might need for packaging while being pretty and sustainable at the same time. So if you want to learn more about them, I'll leave a link to their website in the description box below. But yeah, thank you so much, Noissue. Thank you.
글씨를 연습할 때는 크게 크게 하나씩 그리는 게 좋고요.
So this is voiceover Naisu speaking. I don't know why I think that's important, but yeah, I thought that I just kind of thought that it would be weird if I didn't mention that and you thought I was speaking in the video, but I wasn't. But you know, I don't know what I'm talking about. Anyways, I know that I've been chatting with you at the end of the past few vlogs recently, and I wasn't going to do it this time, but then I just wanted to talk to you about the book I'm reading. Since I've already been talking about books lately, I might as well just continue doing it. But before I talk about the book, I should probably tell you what I'm doing in the video. So I'm just sketching a few things for school. I was gonna do like an overhead thing so you could see what I'm sketching, but then I realized that sometimes the things they make you draw in art school aren't the most friendly for young audiences. How do I explain that? Because I don't wanna, okay. I'm basically drawing nude people for school. That's what I'm doing, yes, in the video, but I didn't wanna show that just cause, you know, just to be safe. I'm just not gonna do that, but anyway. So about the books I've been reading. So if you recalled, in my last video, if you watched it, you don't have to, but if you watched it, I was reading The Cruel Prince by Holly Black, and I gave that book like a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I thoroughly enjoyed it, but it was really slow burn. Like, in the beginning of the book, I didn't expect anything to happen at all, just because we weren't given like anything, like any like drop of romance, and if there was any, it wasn't like a lot, you know, so I just didn't expect anything to happen. But some things did happen, so I was like, oh, that's cool. But it was super slow burn and not much happened, but I enjoyed it. I liked the politics, I liked the game, I like how I was tricked at the end. But again, you know when you start a book and once you start it, you can't put it down? But once you put it down, you kind of forget about it. It's one of those books, if you get what I mean. If you read a lot of books, then you know what I mean. The second book, The Wicked King, I can already tell that I'm going to like this book a lot more than the first one because I just started reading it a few hours ago. I mean, a few hours before I started recording this voiceover. But yeah, and I'm already around like, I guess, 3/4 of the way, 2/3 of the way, and I'm enjoying it so much. I hope that the ending doesn't like ruin everything, but I have like really high hopes for this. I wouldn't say it's completely unpredictable. Just because of the title of the second book and the third book, I can already kind of like, you know, guess what's going to happen to some of the characters. And oh my goodness, I don't want to spoil anything, but there are two characters that we mainly follow, and these two characters don't interact all the time in the second book, nor did they interact all that much in the first book, but the times that they're interacting make it worth the times that they're not interacting, if you get what I'm saying. But yeah, I have really high hopes. I'm not reading anything else at the moment, because before I read The Cruel Prince, I've been reading a lot of Julia Quinn books. If you didn't know Julia Quinn, I didn't either before I started reading her books, but her books are great. They're light and they're historical romance, and I enjoy them. Anyway, yeah, I think that's all I wanted to say. I just wanted to chat with you about some books. I'm currently almost done with finals, which is great, but next semester it's gonna be a lot, so I hope that I still have time to do the things I actually enjoy doing. But Yeah. Let me know if you actually like the little chats at the end of the vlogs, because I kind of enjoy doing them because it's fun talking about books. Anyway, yeah, thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye!